morning, Harrison students and families. This is Ms. Crawford, your Harrison principal. Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. And now for the Harrison Peace Pledge. I am a peacemaker. I pledge to recognize the good people do and make positive choices and help others to do the same. I will build peace at school, at home, and in my community every day.
Hello. So today I have made a pizza, a lunchable, with pepperoni. Here it is. Well, bam. Yes. All right. Peace out. Have a great Friday.
Hi, I'm Viv. And you know there are only two animals in the world that actually like spicy food? It's true. For a long time, scientists thought that only humans like spicy food. But then a Chinese researcher discovered the Chinese true shrew, which is a tiny creature that looks a lot like a mouse, who doesn't taste the spicy in food and will happily gobble it down. Have a great Friday.
This is Did You Know? With Mrs. Fink. Our Lakewood school buildings are named after people who are important to our nation's history. Many are named after presidents who were born in Ohio. Grant Elementary in the center of Lakewood was named after a president and general. He was a general for the North in the Civil War. Ulysses S. Grant created the U.S. Department of Justice and was the first president to meet with many leaders from around the world. He was born in Point Pleasant, Ohio. Harding Middle School was named for Marion, Ohio's Warren G. Harding. This 29th president spent most of his life living in rural Ohio. He was a newspaper man by trade. Harding had a troubled presidency. He died of a heart attack while in office. Hayes Elementary was named for Rutherford B. Hayes. He was the 19th president and was a lawyer from Cincinnati. He served as an Army officer, congressman, and governor before going to the White House. He worked for Jobs for Americans and helped bring peace to South America. William Howard Taft was our 27th president. The Taft Center for Innovation was named for this 6-foot-tall leader. He was born in Cincinnati and is the only president to have served as Chief Justice of the Supreme Court. Lakewood was once home to McKinley Elementary School. It was at Detroit and West Clifton on the west side of the city. It was named for the 25th president, William McKinley, from Niles, Ohio. McKinley Elementary was torn down in 2014. Benjamin Franklin created his own opportunities in life, and it is fitting that the Franklin School of Opportunity is named for this creative man. Franklin wasn't a president, but he was a founding father, writer, inventor, postmaster, vegetarian, and much more. He is even on the $100 bill. Horace Mann Elementary was named for a famous supporter of public education. He was also a congressman and president of Antioch College in Ohio. Emerson Elementary was named for Ralph Waldo Emerson, who was an American writer and poet. He also loved nature and wrote an essay called Nature. Lakewood named two schools after presidents who were from other states. Theodore Roosevelt was the 26th president of the United States. He was famous for his Rough Riders in the Spanish-American War. He worked to preserve our natural resources. He was known as T.R. or Teddy. The teddy bear is named after him. Lincoln Elementary was named after our 16th president, Abraham Lincoln. He was born poor in a log cabin but became president during the Civil War. He was the force behind abolishing slavery. He was killed by an assassin in 1865. Last but not least, Lakewood named our building after President Benjamin Harrison. Harrison was the grandson of a president. He was born in North Bend, Ohio. He was not rich and went to school in a log cabin. He graduated from Miami University and became a lawyer. He was a recruiter for the Union Army, a congressman, and a senator before becoming president. He was our nation's 23rd president, and his legacy of greatness lives on in our Harrison students.
All right, Harrison students, you have guessed it. It's Miss Crawford, and guess what time it is? It's our golden ticket winner time, and so I am here to announce our golden ticket winners for the week. We have Lucas, who received his golden ticket from Miss Weber, and it says, thank you for working extra hard and writing this week. Lucas is one of our new students to Harrison. Welcome to Harrison, Lucas, and congratulations on your golden ticket. We also have Miss Anna, who received her golden ticket from Mrs. Adams. And then we have Glory, who also received a golden ticket from Miss Adams. We have Dion, who received his golden ticket from Miss Weber, and it's for sharing wonderful social studies examples. So great job, Dion. And then finally, we have Carter Denya, who received his golden ticket. So congratulations to you all. We're excited that you have continued to do things above and beyond and that you're working really hard. Continue to work. We will continue to pull our golden ticket winners and share those winners with you. Those of you who received a golden ticket, make sure you keep your eyes open for your special treat that will be headed your way. Hope that you have a wonderful day and a great weekend. Thank you.
Good morning, Harrison families. I have a joke for you today. Why is there a clock in the library? Because it talks too much. And hope you guys have a great rest of the day.
I want you to sing from your soul. I want you to reach with your elbow.